And we're back. And we are at full strength. Aloth isn't at one hit point, and things are good. And this is where we... well, this is right before we went into that battle. We looted this, and we went down there. And I'm pretty sure it's the same stuff. Not sure if it's the same amount of copper. I don't remember stuff like that.
Sure.
Sure. So, yeah. So, yeah, I fought through all that stuff all over again. I went the exact same way. I think we... I started out here. Yeah. So I went around here, followed the crap there. Went up here, didn't go up the stairs, same as last time. Checked out the Grotto of Echoes. Just a few things there, nothing much. The burial grounds. And then went... are these stairs here? Yeah, we went down these stairs and then over here. Block passage, went up. Same thing, Durance got hit again, or he got lost in rubble and then he came out and he was okay. So same exact outcome for everything. The only difference is... is it the Western Wall? Can I even get into it? Yeah. I'm not in combat yet. Yeah, the South Curtain Wall is completed. So now we're gonna do the West Curtain Wall. And let's hope stuff doesn't get undone. And then I guess we'll do the library again. And if things don't get undone again, we'll start actually going to the last three things. Wouldn't that be awesome?
Yes?
Yes, and once again... Well, this time it's... Adair staying behind. You need to come up with us. And fight. Nice. What's that? Oh, why is Aloth in front? What the hell? Belay that. I knew Adair was hanging behind too, but it seemed kind of like too late. Or almost, I don't know. Well, we can't knock down a... what the hell. Can we take over a... Can we ringleader us a specter? So we can do that. And it's too late. He's already linked to this frickin' thing. Just hit it, I guess. I want to get him out of the way as quick as possible. Alright, we're all struggling to get past this crap.
Following you.
I don't know which one we're taking over. She's still casting it. That's a shadow. I forgot to put up our Holy Radiance. Disengage? I think they might have. Cast your spell. Hurry up. We did it. Or she did it. I need to kill Spectre engage Spectre in melee. Just trying to see what we did. One graze, two hit. Alright. Guess that's what we got going on. There's one or two of them fighting for us. Oh! But Aeloth turned evil. So we've traded a specter for Aeloth. Great! Alright, so now we can just attack at will here. Pillar of Faith, boom. Oh, I can't use it, duh. Trying to select Aeloth. Forgot for a second, he's taken over. Palagina. Oh no, don't hit him. Hit that. Awesome. Did we lose our Spectre friend already? Damn, that was quick. Alright, let's see if we can throw a fireball. Get a lot of them, can't we? Oh no, there's our Spectre friend is right there. Alright, don't get him in there. If he runs into the blast of this, he'll probably overcome. And that'll be on the side of evil again. But what are you gonna do? Oh, get this thing off. Burn, baby, burn. Which one are we hitting? Right there? Kill the Will-O-Wisp. Make short work of that. Theodos can hit it too. How about blessing for all our friends and undead friend? And I might have us all accounted for. Okay, we got the Will-O-Wisper ready. Get the Spectre. The Spectre. Oh, he's right there. We can barely see these things. Theodos, you're out of focus. Fight something. That's it! Oh, he's still casting that? Aeloth's got company now. Oh, Palagina. Oh boy. That's not good. Oh boy. Our healer is busy. Get unbusy. Our friend is gone.
Oh.
Yes, thank you. Awesome. The Spectre's almost dead. Oh, hey! I almost forgot about this. You know, I probably forgot it a few times. Oh, he's fighting with his fist. Oh my god. No wonder we're not doing anything. This thing would probably be dead by now. Call the Drake. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome.
Hey.
Well, that's gone. Okay. Attack our foes. Oh, there you go. Yay! See you later, buddy. That was awesome. Look at all them spirit residues. Cool. All right. Anyway.
Hello. Hello.
No problem.
Okay. We haven't been in this little area. If there's anything here, but no. So this comes from, right, these stairs that we didn't go down or go up, rather. Now these balls, these, well, not balls, whatever, they come back. You could see them on the map. When I save the game and reload, they're back again. So, I don't know what the deal is with that. There's more up here now. But they go into Theodas, obviously. I wonder what that feels like. What is this? Mouse over, not working. Ingwithin Adra Ban Amulet, +3 might. Carved from a solid piece of Adra and decorated with woven brass, this amulet appears to be extremely old. It is slightly warm to the touch. Old and warm, huh? Exceptional battle axe, flasks of war paint. Right, we've seen that before. Pretty handy. Plus 15 accuracy, plus 10 damage, and plus 20% maximum endurance. Perhaps we'll end up using that at some point. Maybe. If you're lucky. Okay, we came from there. Okay. So that's that. Apparently we have explored everything except for up these stairs. This is a pretty long battle already. Like 15 minutes in. Or a little more than that, actually. We got three of those suckers. They'll go into DS. Now, what happens? Just curious. If we collect them all. I mean, you don't even have to go through that passage, because you just go up this way. I wouldn't want to miss it, though. I love those little story... like, choose your own adventure. Sorry, that was probably loud. Type of thing. I want to collect all the souls. Let's see if something happens. Like, maybe we get strength from them? Would be cool. Here's from the beginning. Okay, the only ones back up where we came from. Not in there. Doobie doop doop. Bok bok bok. Bok. And these ones. Oh, I missed something here. Don't want to miss out on our spirit residue. Absolutely not. Okay, I got all those. Oh, there's another. Yeah, it's one more. Zoop. Collect them all. Alright, now. The main event. Oh. When did I turn off? I thought I heard that fast turn on.
And what does the flame reveal?
It reveals some steps. So, oh, there's a couple more. Shoop. Hello. Deus, I presume?
Another turn, Inquisitor.
Deus signals some unseen attendant standing beside a large crank.
I ask again. Yovara Ixensios, do you confess to these heresies of which you stand accused?
He waits, but Yovara only stares straight ahead, her face stony, the creak of her restraints the only sound.
Do you confess to apostasy?
I confess to renouncing a mistake.
She opens her mouth to speak, strands of thin spittle spanning from one lip to the other like a spider's threads. Ugh.
Do you confess to conspiracy against the one true faith?
I confess to opening minds.
Do you confess to false prophecy?
I confess to following a false prophet.
Indeed. And where might we find this heretic?
He wears the robes of a Grand Inquisitor.
I knew that's what she was getting at.
You have no followers here, heretic. Your lies hold no sway in the Court of the Penitents.
Only my truth, then.
Iovara seems to look directly at you.
Another turn!
Theos nods to the Inquisitor at the crank. Good job with those screams.
No! Wait! Wait! I'm ready! I'm ready!
You are ready to give a confession?
Theos signals the Inquisitor to hold.
I am ready to hear one from you.
Ooh, she's got spunk. Iovara gasps for breath, gathering up what little strength she has left to speak. Theos shakes his head and points at the Inquisitor, and the scraping grind of rusting gears echoes in your mind as the apparitions fade away. Wow. Oh, he's a sadistic little thing, isn't he?
When you get to the bottom, holler up here. Let me know if it's safe.
Just stay down here? At the center of the Court of the Penitents is a pit so deep that the bottom cannot be seen, nor does it make a noise when pebbles are knocked into it. The fall would surely kill anyone who jumped. Alright, are the gods going to help just me? They were talking about just me, but I need my friends as well to assist me. Any secrets? Hold on.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Certainly try. The pit. Into the pit. I am going to rest here, actually, because I don't know if we'll be able to do so before the next battle. And, I mean, we really don't need to, except for maybe Aloth, so let's rest. Alright. And I'm going to save. Alley-oop! A great pit lies in the shadow of the statue of Whitaka. No light from the surface reaches the bottom, but even so, you catch flickers of a ghostly glow in the depths. A wind from the pit buffets you. It isn't cold, but it raises goose flesh along your arms. The wind carries a whisper, low and sibilant. As you look into the pit, souls gather around you. They encase you in a cloud of essence that swirls around your body while you consider your next move. Into the pit with us. There's quite a stall there. You jump, trusting in the promises of the gods and the power of the souls to bear you safely down. The sudden drop takes your breath away, but the souls catch you, encasing you in a shining, thrumming aura. But while they slow your descent, you can still feel that you are falling faster than you should. The essence flowing around you is strong but chaotic. You find yourself drifting toward the wall. Oh, wow. Let's use our athletics. Flip, directing yourself back to the center of the pit. You steer yourself to the safety of open space. You manage to spread your arms and legs into an X, steadying your position and the rate of your descent. You start to feel more comfortable until you notice that Durance is still falling too fast. Okay, so we do have our friends with us. Donadair said he was going to stay up top. Durance plummets, flailing and out of control. You could attempt a rescue, but the ground is approaching fast. It will take a feat of speed and agility to avoid injury. Durance is always getting in trouble. Is he like the most non-athletic one or something? Or is this actually a scripted event that's supposed to happen to him in the story? Of course, we're gonna die for our companion. The ground is rising fast, and you're not quite fast enough. You snatch Durance out of freefall, but you're unable to regain control over your own momentum in time. You take the brunt of the impact, landing hard against the millennia-old stones of the Court of the Penitents.
After what seems like an eternity, your rapid descent comes to an abrupt end. You remain still for a moment while your heart settles and your eyes adjust, breathing in stale, forgotten air. Before you, a narrow and eroded walkway becomes faintly visible in the dim light, cutting a winding path through a cavern so expansive it seems a world unto itself. In the distance, you can make out the cold gleam of living Audra veins that spike and fork in and out of view from the murky depths beneath. Their glow a faint and fleeting guide along the ancient trail. You look above at the opening you jumped through, now barely a speck of light like some distant star alone in the cosmos and forever out of reach. Your only way lies ahead.
I love these little storytell moments. Hello.
Well, that went better than I expected.
I have survived the fall from the top of the Court of the Penitents. And luckily, not just me. The path before me leads through the Inguithin's eternal prison and, if the Dilemgan sister spoke true, to the sun in shadow where Theos is bound.
Everyone all right? No shattered knees? Good. Just me, then.
That requires the aid of the gods. I've chased Theos into Prith. Eamon is returning back now.
That was bracing. I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
Let's explore our environment. Look at all these bones, man. Spikes. And secret stuff.
This I haven't seen before.
Deedus discovered it, though. So why does he say something? Cool. Camping supplies. A girdle of Aeotin constitution. +3 constitution. Aeotin's feature in the most grotesque of folk tales. Once merely the aggressive and unstable of ogres, Aeotins have since developed into massive monstrosities that are both larger and far less intelligent than their cousins. Aeotins have two heads. Oh, Ettins. One notably smaller than the other. You know, it's probably pronounced Ettin. Just like the D&D monster, Ettin. Only it's, instead of E-T-T-I-N, it's spelled this way. And when the larger of these is incapacitated, the smaller retains just enough brute cunning to keep an Ettin fighting. Named for these monstrosities, this belt provides a charm granting a similar kind of hardy perseverance. I don't think all of us have belts, so this will be handy. Or, waisty. Girdle of Mortal Protection. Oh, that's his knockdown ability. I like that. -27 crit damage taken. I have a whole bunch of that. Was it grant? Of Constitution 3. Is it like D&D where our hit points will go up? Yeah, look at that. She's went from 517 to 572 con. Awesome. Liking it. Trying Trap detected.
Something over there!
Yeah, it's a trap. Something over here. Here, another camping supply. Good, we're full again. Now I don't feel bad we're using them all up. Sleeping so much. Alright, a fine pike. And what is it? A turquoise? Topaz. And 192 copper. What else we got? Anything else? Okay. I hear like whispering. Well, we need to get rid of this trap and that trap.
Something over there. That's settled. That's settled.
Again, 300 XP every time we do that. A millennium's worth of dust fills in the cracks and crevices of this skeletal relief. Same here. Well, before we continue on and get in fights and stuff like that, I will call it an episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time when we explore more of Breathe Aemon. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.